Mafaka Mata is a member of Fatah's Revolutionary Council and chief executive of Fatah's Information and Culture Commission. He joins me now from Ramallah. Let's talk about this paperwork. Why did you feel the need to put this out?
We believe that Hamas is taking a new political course at this moment. Hamas wishes to steer away from the reconciliation among the Palestinians. We also believe that Hamas came up with this document as a step to launch a campaign against the leadership of Fatah. Simply, they believe that Fatah may lead an insurgence against the status quo imposed by Hamas in Gaza Strip. I believe all these reasons and dimensions for going public with this issue at the moment, but above all, Hamas is trying to internalize its crisis with other countries with respect to the countries it is interfering in, like Syria and Egypt. It also wishes to raise issues within the Palestinian territories.
Here, I would like to put out, if I may jump in here, this paperwork has been leaked allegedly from your very own office.
I am in position now, two samples of documents. The first one on top, if you look at the letterhead, this is the official letterhead used by us in the Information and Culture Commission. And this one below is the letterhead used by Hamas to come with its falsified and fabricated stories. If you look at the right side in Arabic, we say Information and Culture Information Commission. They say only the Information Commission. We use our original letterheads while they use the English part, which means the Commission of External Affairs. The External Affairs Commission is independent from the Information and Culture Commission, which is ours. This clearly proves that these letterheads are forged and falsified. I am here with samples of the original letterheads and those forged and falsified. This is only a sample.
Okay, let me ask you quickly then. I mean, so it's not true that you would be fabricating news to spread information that would ruin the image of Hamas in Egypt? Because obviously with the change of leadership now, it's going to be in your benefit, isn't it?
Yes, that's true. We were aware that we did not wish to go public with this issue simply for the reason that we do not wish to smear the image of Hamas, as we consider Hamas is part and parcel of the Palestinian people, even if Hamas has committed a mistake interfering in the domestic affairs of other countries. However, from the very first, we had clear and accurate information that Hamas is interfering in the domestic affairs of Egypt and Syria. We were adamant to keep this as a confidential matter, as we know the grave consequences on each and every Palestinian citizens. That's why we did not go public with all this information, which we had learned earlier enough. And so long as Hamas is blaming Fatah for all what is suffering, including the incitement and provocation in the Egyptian media outlet, and also the Palestinian people have suffered.
We are running out of time, so excuse me jumping in here. What sort of impact do you think it'll have on the talks, on the Middle East talks, considering that it just shows the differences and the problems that still remain between Fatah and Hamas?
That's true. We believe that it will have grave consequences on the Middle East talk. Personally speaking, I can say that the media, the press conference organized by Hamas today on the forged documents is a desperate attempt to regain the confidence in the alliances it used to have, like Syria and Hezbollah. Hamas wishes to restore its position as a line of resistance. This is to block the relaunch of the peace talk. Hamas wouldn't have achieved this unless it clearly states that it is standing on opposite direction with the Palestinian Authority and Fatah. It is also prepared to obey the orders of the other parties who are opposing the peace talk.
Apologies, my apologies for that. Thank you very much for talking to us here on Al Jazeera.